Praise God, dear heart. This is Evangelist King, Deliverance Pastor at House Shalom, where we're simply building a peaceful house for God's glory. You know, something had been laid heavily upon my heart. It happened probably about 3 or 4 years ago. You know, the good Lord, He always sends those to His ministry of the Children's Might, which is located at www.thechildrensmite.org. But He had mentioned to me many years ago that He's going to send His dear children to me because they've been crying out to Him for help, especially in the area of deliverance. They know that there are demonic spirits who is living in their lives and then wrecking their lives. And they want to be set free. So He told me He would send them to me. So this particular young woman who God sent a few years ago, when she came, I think she probably was about 7 to 8 months pregnant at that time. So as she began to share her story, and the Holy Spirit began to do His spiritual probing in her life, sure enough, she had a spirit husband. Also, she was connected to a generational curse of idolatry and family witchcraft. But dear Lord, again, when God sends you to His servant, He's just not sending you to His servant to get information from His servant. But after the information, His aim is to use that very same servant and setting you totally free by confronting those demons that are residing dormantly in the mind, the will, the emotion, and the body, and taking and using their authority and command in Christ Jesus and commanding them to come out. That is always God's intention, His intention for her. So, therefore, long story short, I confronted the spirits in her. Quite naturally, they manifested, and quite naturally, Jesus cast them all out. As I reminded the Lord Himself of His will to be done on earth as it is in heaven. But dear heart, God set her free. He sets us free. But do you not know that it's up to us to remain free? Just like when we become saved, born again, we have to stay saved, stay born again. We have to maintain our salvation because you can backslide if you choose to do so. So we have to maintain every gift that God has given us. We must maintain that gift. That includes salvation, healing, and deliverance. Healing and deliverance, we have to maintain it. Dear Lord, when God healed us, that don't mean we can eat and drink everything and expect to stay healed. No, we all got a part to play in this. Same way with deliverance. You know, we have to submit ourselves, because submit our lives, our ways, all our ways unto the Lord. Then when the devil brings in his temptation, we'll be able to resist it, and then he will run from us. So remember, even after your deliverance, devil's going to try to come back, because that's what the deliverer said. Remember, we are just vessels, His servant. Jesus Christ Himself is a deliverer. He said, "For unclean spirits are cast out of a person. They go seeking for a new home. And upon finding them, they said, let me go back from where I came. And have the audacity to call you their house. Let me go back to my old house, my former house, my house." And they're going back to see if you are in submission to God. If not, you open the door for them to come back. But this time, they say, well, I'm not going back by myself. I'm going to bring 7 more demon spirits that are more powerful and more wicked than I am. And that will secure my state. So that was what Jesus said, okay? So, dear heart, I'm here to share with you and tell you, even after your deliverance, you have to watch the people that you choose to be around. You have to beware of false prophets. Remember now, you left Satan's kingdom, and those demons are out of you now. And Satan is saying he wants you back. So that means he can have to send a person into your life to speak lies into you, to accuse God's children, because he's accused of the brethren. To accuse God's children, he would do so. Now, with this particular young lady, what the devil did to her, he whispered lies in her hearing. Remember, he's an accuser. He's accuser of the brethren. He's accuser of we who have received the Lord, who serve the Lord. We are believers in the Lord. So he accused us night and day. So he started by coming back with some accusation against the very person whom God used, the vessel he used to set her free. And whatever it was, dear heart, instead of her rebuking the devil, she kept giving ear. And when you give ear to the devil, dear heart, he'll let you hear, he'll let you see exactly what you are expecting to hear and what you are expecting to see. So he can say, see, I told you so. So in other words, dear heart, the devil do not want us to fellowship with those who are like-minded in Christ Jesus. He don't want you to fellowship with the right people, with the children of God, who's in unity in the Holy Spirit. He does everything in his power to separate us one from another. Because when we come together, we're more powerful together than we are singular. Now, we may be powerful singular because of Christ Jesus through his Spirit, but you know, we are even more powerful when we come together, when brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, of like-minded in the Lord, abiding in the Lord, we come together in unity in the Holy Spirit. It's like setting off a nuclear explosion in the spirit realm. And dear heart, that means our prayers are effectual, they are powerful, and they are fervent. Why? Because we are the righteousness of God through Christ Jesus by his Spirit. So again, the devil did not want her to continue fellowshipping with me. Because the devil knows whoever fellowship with me, out of my mouth always comes the praises of God. Out of my mouth always is spoken the glorious wonders of God. He is the lover of my soul. So how you know who's the lover of your soul? You determine it by what comes out of your mouth. Who are you talking about? Or what are you talking about? Who or what you talking about? That is the lover of your soul. And the devil knows Jesus Christ is the lover of my soul. So I just want to share with you this subtle trick. Now, this was a very subtle trick of the enemy to use against this young lady to go back into what he say his out. So first of all, he had to separate us. This was his plot and plan, as the Lord had let me see through these number of years, because I questioned the Lord about her. You know, everyone I do deliverance on, from time to time, the Holy Spirit bring them back to my remembrance, and I would question the Lord, and the Lord let me know what they're doing. So, with this young lady, the devil said, I got to get her away from that woman. That's what the devil called me, that woman. You know, some of you have a tendency to say, Terry. No, just disregard the position that God put me in as an evangelist. You say, Terry. No, it's not Terry. Because personally, you don't know Terry. I'm not on Facebook to personally get to know you as Terry. But I'm on Facebook as a servant of the Most High God. And we need to give God's servant respect and honor instead of letting that defiant spirit call us to rebel against God and against God's servant. So the enemy said first, I must get her away from that woman. Again, talking about Evangelist King, because as long as she is affiliated and attached to her, she always leads her to Christ Jesus. And that would cause us never be able to go back to our house. So the devil started again by accusation. He whispered accusation in the ear. You know, whenever the devil whispers accusation in your ear and you don't immediately rebuke him, but you kind of ponder it in your mind, and it seeps down into your heart, dear heart, it's going to come out your mouth. It's going to come out through your mouth and back and through your actions. So in this case, again, he accused me to her. So she thought about it in her mind. And then one day she spoke to another young lady who God had delivered through our program. What was in her mouth? What was in her mind and in her heart? She spoke it out through her mouth. Now, the moment she spoke that out through her mouth, the devil said, I got you. I got you. Okay. Now, again, the subtle trap that was the main way that the devil entered was whispering that accusation regarding God's servant. Because, you know, if you don't believe God's servant, you cannot receive God through his servant. You will reject God. Now, I know you say, well, I never reject God. Yes, you do. When you reject his servant, You actually have rejected God. So you can go to any other servant of God. Remember, it's God who you rejected. So when you go to another servant of God, God still is not going to answer you. That's why you're going to end up calling false prophets. And so, in other words, this young lady, again, allowed the enemy to whistle that accusation to separate her from me. Now, I never separate from her. She's still in my heart. But she has separated from me. Now, the next thing the enemy said, remember what I did for you. Now, when the enemy came to her, he didn't come to her in plain clothes as the enemy. He came to her in this voice, a false truth. It was a false Holy Spirit whispering and talking to her. So now you remember how you and your husband could never have a baby. Look at you now. You're pregnant. And I spoke that pregnancy through, you know, the devil say, a man of God, but it's not capital G, it's a small g. And didn't it come to pass? Of course she's going to say yes, because she's pregnant. And if she would share that testimony with you, you would say, oh, that was God's doing. That person prophesied that pregnancy was truly of God. Okay. In her case, it was not so. It was a subtle trap of the enemy. Because the enemy had some idea that God's plan was to set her totally free. So he had to have this plot in mind to get her back. Now, according to her own testimony that she shared with me, of course, you know, before she came to me, she was already pregnant. So she would come to be delivered from that spirit husband in witchcraft, spirit husband witchcraft. So, out of her mouth, she said, her husband had left her for some months, I believe. He'd been gone for a while, not intending to return back. And there she was, pregnant without a husband, you know, and everything. And then she said that, again, he had left her, all right? Then she said, one day, all of a sudden, he came back. And quite naturally, he came back. She was rejoicing because she thought it was of God. She thought he came back and that because God was sending him back. Quite naturally, when he come back, devil say, that's your husband. It's no sin that you sleep with your husband. So she slept with her husband. Now, I don't know how many years prior to that, before the breakup, that they tried for a baby and never got a baby. But it just so happened, when he came back, she got pregnant. And do you not know, after he slept with her that night, the next day he got up and left, never came back again. He never came back again, okay? Now, I found out later, through this other sister that she has spoken to, that it was a prophet from Nigeria, who prophesied to her that her husband should have a baby. So, after her deliverance, again, the enemy wanted to separate her from me. The enemy brought all that up. Well, didn't the prophet or man of God prophesy your pregnancy and you got pregnant? She said, yes. So now go fellowship with him. Now, dear heart, think about this matter. Now, remember, Satan do not cast out devils, for that is his kingdom. He's not divided against himself. Now, if that prophet from Nigeria was truly a man of God, the first thing the Holy Spirit would have done through him was to cast those devils out of her, spirit husband in witchcraft. Then he would have had her to intercede in the spirit for her husband and going to our Heavenly Father, asking the Heavenly Father to do whatever it takes to bring her husband back to him, because after all, he had been unfaithful to God, then unfaithful to her. Because when he go back to God, then God will make him faithful, then he'll be able to go back to his wife. Okay? That's if that was the Holy Spirit. Then they would have had a baby, and he would have been right there, even to this day, with that young lady. But dear heart, that spirit in that prophet was not the Holy Spirit. It was a false Holy Spirit. because when she came to me, she needed to be delivered. Dear heart, God don't do such a work. He don't send your husband back for one night for you to have sex and get pregnant and then tell him to leave again, never to return. That was not the Lord. That was Satan. That was Satan who suggested in her husband to go, because he's an agent that Satan is using to do his evil bidding. He said, go back to your wife, because I need her to believe me. Go back to your wife. Sleep with her. And I will stop trying to prevent that pregnancy. Now, Satan cannot give life. Life comes from Jesus Christ. But Satan can prevent or hinder that life from coming. And that's what Satan had been doing all the while in her marriage, her other marriage. He had been hindering that life from coming. He cannot give life. He hinders it. He hinders it. And what gives him legal right is disobedience. What he gave him legal right was because those spirits was in her and her husband. So this woman has said, well, after all, the prophet was the one who prophesied me to be pregnant, and now it became pregnant, so I'm going to go follow him instead. Dear, beware of false prophets. Beware of the subtle scheme of the enemy. Just because something looked right doesn't mean that it is right. And my heart still goes out for her son. I say she had a son, but her child now is a few years old now. And I still cry in my heart for her. And not only her, but many others. The devil had done the same way. Devil aim, as he did our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, is to accuse us night and day. Accuse us night and day of this, of that, so people can believe it, so that it can hinder their faith in receiving from God. Because again, when you reject God's servant, you have rejected God. The devil do not want us to come together, God's children, to come together in unity of the Spirit. Again, dear heart, every time you see a healing, every time you see a miracle or a deliverance, you need to inquire, you know, with the right reason for wanting to know. Cry to the Holy Spirit. Is this work of you? And he'll say, well, who is getting glorified here? Is Jesus Christ getting glorified? Or is the person being glorified? Because again, dear, I'm telling you, many of you, your spouse has left you. And the devil told him or her to come back. And they goes back. And there you think God sent them back, when it was the enemy to send them back, to draw your emotion, your affection off of God and back onto your spouse. And once they succeed in doing that, they end up leaving you again. I minister to many women that happened to. Some men, but most women that have happened to. Dear heart, don't allow the enemy to cause you to disfellowship with true believers in Christ Jesus. There's a reason why God connects us together. And that reason is to give us spiritual strength and to make us stronger and stronger in our faith in Him when we come together in unity of the Holy Spirit. Again, dear heart, that was not God who sent that woman husband back, because God don't do such a work. Again, He doesn't do such a work, send your spouse back to impregnate you and then leave again. That was the devil to accomplish and fulfill his plan against her in her life. And my prayer is that God would let her see that truth. She haven't seen that truth yet, that she would see that truth. And, you know, God forbid, but there's a big possibility that she ended up sleeping with and going with that false prophet in Nigeria. I'm purposely calling out the nation, Nigeria, the country, Nigeria, because of a lot of false prophets in Nigeria, men who target weak women here in the United States, making them believe that God sent them as their internet husband. They call yourself being married over the internet. Woman not knowing in America that he's already married over there. Already married over there, but he's hiding. Most of those false prophets in Nigeria, They are nothing but witch doctors. They schemers. They professional witch doctor. And those spirits, they know your weakness. You need to get your mind off of having an earthly man. Put your mind on having a spiritual man who is Jesus Christ. And let him decide whether you need a earthly man. Because right now, you done made a mess. You done made a mess of things, and that's why you're still in a mess. Why? Because you're trying to find that man. You don't know where to look. Same thing applies to the men looking for women, looking for wives. You don't know where to look. You don't know who to look for. You need to trust the Lord. Trust the Lord. So that was on my heart that I wanted to share. So you can take it however you want to take it. I pray that you take it as encouragement. And it will help you in your daily walk with the Lord. That choice is yours. But one thing I want you to know, dear heart, you do not send me any disgruntled email or mail. Emails or mail. Okay? You take that up with the Holy Spirit. Some of you say, I just got to let Vengeance King know how I feel. It's best you keep your mouth closed. You know, that's what kind of most people in problem now, because they're not learning to keep their mouth closed. You know, the Christians say, well, I disagree. When I speak, I don't ask for your agreement. That's up to you to agree or not. Praise the living God. It just shows me that you're very disrespectful to authority. Many times I heard people in authority speak, and it wasn't something I agreed with. I didn't let them know. I say, no, Lord, because your word says this, that, and the other. And I would smile at them, love them, and I would not judge them. I don't come out and say, I don't agree. You hurt yourself. Again, dear, you know, when we don't watch what comes out of our mouth, we defile ourselves. Be careful. Be careful what you allow the enemy make you think and turn around and make you say. You know what? You think evil before you speak evil. So when a person up and tell me, I don't believe you, that shows me that you have been thinking evil. You've been thinking evil about the things that I say or the thing and or the things that I do. Because what's in the heart, the mouth is going to speak. If it was not in the heart, you would never speak it. Praise the living God. So dear Lord, for all of those, you know you need deliverance. Now, I truly believe, and it's from my experience, we might not totally realize, but to some degree, at some point we will realize that devils are dominantly living in us. Well, how do we know? Our actions are reaction. It's not that of the Holy Spirit. You question yourself, why I'm acting that? Why did I think? Why did I do that? Why did I say that? That means that those devils are in you. And they need to be confronted and commanded to come out in Jesus' mighty name. Now, for those of you who truly seeking the Lord, with all your heart, mind, soul, and body, most of you, you're not wholeheartedly seeking him. You have wholeheartedly seeking him. And that's why he have not let you find him yet. Because he said he only allow you to find him when you see him wholeheartedly. So, again, if you wholeheartedly is seeking the Lord, and you know you need to live, you know those spirits in you need to come out of you. That's that strong man. You cannot cast that strong man out of yourself. You need some help. And Jesus Christ had dedicated his authority to his body on earth. You need the Lord to lead you to your human helper. Now, not you thinking this is your human helper. The Lord himself leads you to your human helper. One he have chosen and appointed and anointed for this great task in giving out his mercy and grace, in his showing his mercy and grace and compassion. So when God leads you in wanting to be delivered, especially to his ministry, the children of mine, it's not my ministry, it's his. He's the one who came up with the name, he came up with the high idea, he came up with the plan, he came up with the vision and everything. You know, I'm just a steward over his ministry, a faithful steward over his ministry. Then I want you to go to the website, thechildrensmite.org. Now that's the main, I have several websites, but that's the main website that's connected to all the other websites. And I want you to just peruse that website And when you peruse the website, you will come up on information on how to call in for a deliverance session or visit us once a month at our Holy Ghost Fire Deliverance meeting, because sometimes you do need Holy Ghost hands laid upon you. It's very important. And do as the Holy Spirit leads you. That's the childrensmite.org. childrensmite.org. Praise the living God. And dear heart, I truly look forward to ministering God's loving grace and mercy to you, because when he comes back, he's not coming back for a church with spot or wrinkle. No, dear one. We're going to be white as snow. Praise the living God. It's time for us to complete and do the will of our Heavenly Father through his Son Jesus by his Holy Spirit, because our days are short in number upon this earth. It's time for us to go forth strong in the power of his might. Praise God. And setting captives free. Glory to his holy name. So, dear hearts, again, this Evangelist King, Deliverance Pastor at House Shalom. And yes, dear heart, I am a female exorcist. As a matter of fact, every believer in Christ Jesus should have those signs following them, according to the Word of God. And one of the signs is they shall cast out devils. So, therefore, that makes us an exorcist. Praise the living God. Stay blessed, dear heart. In Jesus' mighty name, Shalom.